the fact that you really focus on understanding the social impacts of machine learning in a philosophically coherent way, is the way it says on your website. Mm-hmm. Is that kind of what the tension was here, ultimately, on OpenAI? Philosophical at that?
I think it's important to draw a big distinction. There's a contingent of this community that is more focused on the idea of AI as a potential existential risk to humanity. And there's a bunch of us who are more a group of social scientists, ethicists, some maybe socially inclined computer scientists who've looked at these problems from different angles, more focused on the near-term terrestrial actual harms of AI systems as operationalized in businesses today. So there's this a lot of work that I think very few people disagree is like serious or real problems and important today about understanding how we think about privacy, accountability, transparency, where liability goes once you have a greater degree of automation in our decision-making systems. But on the other side, there's a group of people who are more focused on something what they call X-risk, or this idea that AI is careening towards, you know, by mechanisms known or unknown, that there's this marching progress towards something that is a different kind of threat that needs to be regarded as more of like an epoch-changing event, something more analogous to nuclear weapons. And I'd say that like my work sits a little bit more in what they might call near-termism, and the, this group of effective altruists, their philosophical position is that they think that however small the threat, if the risk, if they're wrong, is a wiping out of humanity, that this is the most important priority in the world. And I'd say it's a relatively fringe belief among technologists, among business people. But it does have some very well-heeled backers, and it does have quite a bit of a foothold in San Francisco,
right.
And in particular research labs. And OpenAI does have some amount of influence of this existentialist thinking.
Right, Zachary, whether the existential threat is a fringe idea or not, what is, I think we can agree on, the events of the last weekend being monumental, I guess, within your career, both in academia and building generative AI tools. Just reflect quickly on what you made of the last 48 to 72 hours.
Oh, well, it's quite wild, given that when I entered the field 10 years ago, I had to explain to my parents what machine learning and AI were, and they were just glad that I wasn't, you know, trying to make a living playing the saxophone anymore. So to go from there to it's the front page of the New York Times that there's a kerfuffle at an AI startup is pretty wild. You know, I think in general, we're watching before our eyes the maturation of an industry. And a lot of how we got here, and I think you see this all over the economy. I think we saw this with the dot-com bubble and some amount of discord and some amount of insanity as we went from a sort of first generation set of companies with strange governance structures and you know, a certain kind of velocity to a more mature environment that followed. You know, it didn't spell the doom of the internet, but it certainly was like a growing up period. I think what we're watching before our eyes is us moving from a period of this being brand new technology and people behaving in strange ways that are sort of exceptional by any normal standards to a period that's going to follow, which is going to be more robust.
Right.
It's going to involve people depending on a much wider and more stable ecosystem of services provided by a larger set of companies.